Build update number two on the Toyota SR86 endurance race car. We quickly realized that with such a short time frame available to build this car, we didn't have enough hours in the day to do all of the work that was required. And fabrication on this car was a pretty big project in and of itself. So we called in the pros, the team that had already done such a great job on our Mazda FD RX-7 project car, Lars and James from Vinny Fab up in Christchurch. They reached out and asked if we needed a hand, and we're not ones to look a gift horse in the mouth, so we said yes. They drove down from Christchurch and immediately got stuck in, producing some amazing work as usual in an incredibly short time frame. I'll hand over to Tim and he can take you through what they achieved.
Called in some reinforcements. We've got the boys from Vinny Fab over here. They've come down to help us for the weekend. We've got a bit of a list for them.
So basically they're going to sort out our full exhaust, turbo back, wastegate, the intercooler. They make custom making an intercooler and everything to fit the car, all the piping.
For us it's just a really big help. We've got a really great fabricator here, but we have so much work to do. It's great to have some help. Yeah, this is going to give us a really good boost. To get the car a bit further along and hopefully get out a bit earlier to do some good testing. Looking forward to a busy weekend. So the guys have only been at it for a couple of hours. We've made some pretty good progress already.
On one side of the table, intercooler's coming together. It's going to have some mounts coming out the top tanks there. On the other side of the table, starting to work on modifications to the exhaust manifold. And they've already done a new outlet on the turbo. Just still in progress, but they're well into their work here. Looking good.
So the boys from Vinny Fab are less than 24 hours into the build here and they've made some fantastic progress. Let's show you around.
So they've got the intercooler mounted right on top of the radiator there. They've done a great job getting some nice mounts on the top. We'll also be adding some more bracing down here to the front of the car, so that'll be nice and solidly mounted. We've got the wastegate nicely mounted on there, all finished up. Lots of room. We'll be moving this wiring, everything will be coming out of here and getting redone, otherwise temperature could be a bit of a problem there. We've got the downpipe in and running about halfway down the car, almost to the gearbox. That's all done. Turbo outlet's been modified. Turbo inlet's been modified for a V-band clamp, which is nice. Now from here, they're going to be doing the intercooler piping. We're just sorting out the last of the V-band clamps and they'll be getting close to wrapping up. So the jobs left for the boys is going to be the inlet to the intercooler here, coming through here, joining up to the turbo. Same thing with the outlet of the intercooler, up to the throttle body. We've got the blow-off valve, will sit somewhere around here. The wastegate outlet, which needs to be run down here next to the downpipe, and we'll join back into the downpipe out of the turbo somewhere before the end of the transmission. We'll find a place for the turbo inlet to plumb back into the air filter. At the moment we're planning on having a duct running from the back of the radiator up through the bonnet. We just need to plan a little bit. We'll probably just bring it hard down this side, which will give us a little bit more room on the radiator, because we don't really want to be in a position where that where we've got the turbo inlet interfering with the duct and making that more complicated than it needs to be. This is the view from underneath the car with the turbo downpipe where it's at the moment. So up there we can see the exhaust manifold and the outlet of the wastegate up there. So that's not quite on the right angle at the moment, but we are going to rotate that a little bit and bring it down through here and merge it back into the downpipe somewhere before we get to the transmission mount, just because there's not that much room to fit two pipes through there. We should be fine getting one 3-inch pipe. The guys made a fair bit more progress here. Downpipe's on the wastegate and it is joined into the turbo downpipe, outlet of the turbo into the intercooler is coming along well. So it's just going to run pretty straight along here into the top of the intercooler we've got it running like that because we want to leave ourselves plenty of room for a duct here. And this side's getting prepared as well for the outlet. We're running up there. Looking good. Here's one of the turbo outlet pipes. We've got some bungs welded in there for temperatures and pressures of the outlet of the turbo. James is getting ready to do the final weld up on the intercooler. This is how it looks as it's all tacked up. Just getting ready for final weld. Vinny Fab boys just finished up for the night. Just gone home. Made some really good progress today. Let's have a look. So we've got everything for the intake and intercooler buttoned up for the moment. You can see straight from the turbo, the loops through to give us some room through the engine bay there, right into the top of the intercooler. A nice little loop back, straight into the inlet. Really short run, so really nice. Got the blower valve mounted there. Wastegate and downpipe all mounted, all finished up. Really nicely packaged, looks great. So from underneath the car, you can see the exhaust from the wastegate. Nicely tied in to the main exhaust. So tomorrow, the boys will run the exhaust down through here, through the gearbox, right up to somewhere around the diff at the back here. We're gonna get them to leave it somewhere around here, this area. We're going to try to run it hard up against the cross member, but finish somewhere about here, because once they are done and have gone home, we will be looking to start mounting the diffuser and look at how we're going to package the exhaust and everything around that. We've got a fair few ideas about how we're going to manage that, but we won't know exactly how it's going to package until we get the diffuser set on there. And there's a few other things we need to get right before we can finalize exactly where all the aero components go. Got to do some suspension mock-up and stuff like that. And then we'll know where all the aero bits are going to go. But overall, really happy with how it's come out so far. So tomorrow's job, going to finish up that exhaust run to the back. And also run the intake down here and along here. So the original position of the air filter was somewhere around here. And it ran up into the center of the inlet there with the V8. We've decided the best way to package it. Well, it's quite a convenient place to have the filter. There's a fair bit of room up here with the bumper coming over to the crash bar. It's an easy place to feed cold air to it as well. So instead, we think we're gonna package it somewhere around here. Just have a slight bend in here and run it up somewhere in that proximity up to the front of the turbo. The reason we wanna keep it over to this side and not run it straight over the top to the turbo is we're gonna have to build a duct for the radiator and intercooler outlet. And we want to use this area up in here. So sort of higher and more to one side of the car, the more room we'll have to build a nice smooth duct there without having to have too many notches. We'll have to see exactly how much room we've got because it's always a bit tighter than you think. Massive weekend here at HPA. Thanks a lot to the Vinny Fab guys that came in and saved us. Put in a massive effort to get everything done. All the welding, intercooler piping, intake and everything done on the front of the car. New intercooler, new exhaust. Fantastic job. Everything here, you can see they've done brand new intercooler, custom end tanks, everything over the top of the engine, really short runs to everything. New inlet, new exhaust, comes in with the wastegate and everything. Looks fantastic. Ready to start again tomorrow on the rest of the jobs, of which there are plenty.
So that's where we're at the moment. If you like this episode, give us a thumbs up. If you've got questions on anything that we cover, please ask those in the comments and make sure you subscribe. This way you'll make sure you don't miss out on any future episodes.